Hi, my name is Richard Crossley, the Crossley ID Guide. I'm out here in the world that I love. Birds, beautiful scenery. And that's what I tried to capture in the book. I tried to create plates that look just like this, from close up to very distant, and everything in between, all in focus, just like we see. To do that, I had to take a gazillion photos. Of that, I chose 10,000 of them and put them into the book, of course using modern technology. But the book's more than just pretty plates. The whole idea of the book was to help you become better birders. So how did we do that? I created a book for everybody, from beginners to experts. The beginning of the book, on the first two pages, it shows a synopsis of all the species, done very simplistically. From there, we go to actually 14 pages, where very briefly we have cutouts of all regularly occurring species that are in the book. Using those pages, you can go straight to the one that you think you've seen. It shows all the sizes, comparative, something that's very hard to do in books, and of course all their shapes and colour patterns. And from there you can go to the main body of the book, which is the beautiful plates. There are approximately 650 of those. In between there is the rest of the introduction. It's different to other books. I'm a no-nonsense person, and the introduction is no nonsense. It tells you how to look at birds and how to use the book. Some of this is a little topical, and I'm sure it's going to create lots of discussion, but I think you'll find it interesting. And then of course there's the plates themselves. They're different to anything you will have ever seen before. You might find them a little confusing at first. After all, you're not used to it. But once you get your eye in and you get used to looking at them, you'll see they're very educational. At the front of the plates, I have all the main plumages, ages and sex labelled. One of everything that's representative. From there, you can look further back through the plates. There are more images of these same examples, but smaller, medium-sized, and in the distance very small. Of course, they're all in habitat that you would expect to see them in. This is so important in identification, and we also incorporate lots of behavior, different poses, whether they occur in flocks or alone. There are so many different things. I can't really go into all of them on this video, but if you get the book, it will teach you a lot. And if you're not bothered about learning, it doesn't really matter, because I think it looks good. I hope you do too.